Welcome to the Parrott Centre at Loyalist College. Discover your library at loyalistlibrary.com. This video is one in a series that explores searching and research skills. In this video, we'll learn about peer review, what it is, why it's important, and how you can find peer-reviewed content using Catalyst and other library databases. Imagine that you've been asked to do an assignment, and your instructor tells you to use peer-reviewed or scholarly sources. What do they mean by this? When we say that an article is peer-reviewed or scholarly, we mean that it's been reviewed by a group of people who specialize in the same subject area as the author of the article, or their peers, hence peer review. Prior to being published, the article is carefully reviewed for accuracy, scientific validity, and quality. Because journals that publish peer-reviewed content will not publish articles that fail to meet certain standards, peer-reviewed articles that are approved for publication demonstrate the best research and research practices in a field of study. Why is peer review so important? When it comes to doing research, if you're using peer-reviewed sources, you know that they've been carefully evaluated by scholars in your field and that the research you're looking at is of high quality. What kinds of sources are considered peer-reviewed? There are three categories of articles that you'll find in journals, sometimes called periodicals. The first are newspaper and magazine articles. These are written by reporters who might or might not be experts in the subject of the journal. Typically, news and magazine articles do undergo fact-checking and editing, but they do not go through the secondary peer review process. Second, there are journals that are not peer-reviewed, such as trade journals. These contain articles written by academics and professionals. Although the authors might be considered experts, the articles haven't been checked for accuracy or quality by anyone other than the authors and the journal editor. And third, as we now know, peer-reviewed or scholarly journals contain articles that are written by experts and are reviewed for quality and accuracy by other experts before the article is published. How can you tell if the article you're looking at has been peer-reviewed? It's important to remember that not all information in a peer-reviewed journal is actually peer-reviewed. For example, editorials, letters to the editor, book reviews, and other types of information don't count as articles, so they don't go through the peer review process. There are a few things that you can look for to determine if the article you're looking at has been peer reviewed. Ask yourself, who published the journal where you found the article? Was it published or sponsored by a professional society or a university academic department? Or was it published by another organization that might have a different agenda? Does the journal describe itself as peer reviewed? If you're unsure about this, you can check the journal's website. Is the topic of the article narrowly focused and explored in depth? Is the article based on either original research or authorities in the field instead of personal opinion? Is the article written for readers who have some prior knowledge of the subject matter? Is the article divided into sections that have headings such as introduction, background, methods, results, conclusion, and more? And last but not least, did you find the article in a database that includes scholarly or peer-reviewed publications? If you're not sure, you can read the database description to see what it does include. And if you've been searching in a library database or in Catalyst, did you limit your search to scholarly or peer-reviewed publications? Now that we know what peer-reviewed content is and why it's so important, how do we find it? Catalyst, the library's search tool, along with many databases the library subscribes to, have built-in tools to help you find peer-reviewed content. First, let's take a look at Catalyst. You can find Catalyst by going to the library's website at www.loyalistlibrary.com. When you arrive at loyalistlibrary.com, you'll find Catalyst about halfway down the page. You can use Catalyst to search for information in the different collections purchased by the library, including the books on our shelves and the electronic content in our databases. A database is a searchable collection of information. In a library, a database is where you'll find journal and news articles, reports, streaming videos, and more. Let's do a search in Catalyst for peer-reviewed content on global business communication. We type our search, no more than two or three words, into the box and click search. On the next screen, we see our results, which are in the center of the screen, and to the left, filters to narrow down our search. Don't forget, if you're working off campus, you'll need to sign in to your library account to view the full text of articles and ebooks, view streaming videos, and to use all of the built-in features in Catalyst. If you haven't already signed in, you'll see a prompt at the top of the screen reminding you to do so. Your library login is the same as your My Loyalist login. Once you've signed in, your name will appear in the top right corner of the screen. Catalyst searches the library's physical collection, the books on our shelves, as well as our electronic resources, including journal articles. To narrow down your search to peer-reviewed content, look at the left side of your screen. You'll see a heading that reads Availability, and underneath it, some search options, including peer-reviewed journals. When we click on this, the page will refresh, and we see peer-reviewed journals at the top of the screen under active filters. Now we know that all of the results in this list come from peer-reviewed journals. Remember that not all content in a peer-reviewed journal goes through the peer-review process. To limit your search to peer-reviewed articles, scroll down to the Format filter and choose Articles. Now we know that all of the results in this list are peer-reviewed articles. You can also search databases one by one to find peer-reviewed content. Let's take a look at one of these databases to see some similarities and differences compared to Catalyst. We'll go back to loyalistlibrary.com, and this time we'll click on the eResources button. This opens a list of all of the different databases purchased by the library. Because Catalyst searches all of the library's databases, not all of the results will be relevant to your specific topic. So, if you're focused on one very specific subject area, it can be helpful to search a database directly. Since we're going to use the same search we used in Catalyst, let's pick a database that focuses on that subject area. Go to the drop-down box labeled Subject. Here, you can pick a broad subject area that best matches the subject of your search. Since we're using an example of a business-related topic, we'll choose Business Databases. This new list contains databases that focus on one broad subject area. In this case, business. Remember that not all databases carry peer-reviewed content, so read the descriptions of each database carefully to find out what kind of content they do have. If you're not sure, contact the library for help. For our sample search, we're going to choose Canadian Business and Current Affairs. You'll see that this database looks different from Catalyst. It's important to remember that the screen you see will look different depending on which database you choose, because these databases are created by different companies. But regardless of which database you pick, searching works the same way. Use the search box to enter no more than two or three terms and click Search. You'll see that this database has the option to limit your search to peer-reviewed content right below the search box. Let's try this using the same search we used in Catalyst, Global Business Communication. On the results page, you'll see the same option to limit to content from peer-reviewed journals on the left side of the screen, just in case you forgot to select it when you started your search. Remember that the options to filter your search might be located on a different part of the screen, depending on which database you chose. If you can't find what you need, contact the library. And that's it. Now you know what peer review is, why it's so important, and how to find peer-reviewed content using both Catalyst and individual library databases. This video is one in a series that explores searching and research skills. The other videos in this series will introduce you to creating a search strategy, searching in Catalyst, and more. We've also created a handout that you can use to guide you through finding peer-reviewed content. If you have questions or need extra help, get in touch with us using the contact information below.